Hello again. This is the fourth and the last part in trading strategies that work. This is being called the beauty of a trend line, how a trend line offers important support and resistance area. Illustrated here first on the theory side, on the first part of this project, the support, and this support area becomes a resistance area. Everything should be mentioned in when price is forming the same, but the other way around, when resistance turns into support, when support turns into resistance, and resistance turns into support. See here, the resistance turns into support, and then support turns into resistance. To recap a bit what we've discussed, or to review what we've discussed, the upper trend line and the lower trend line here should be traded by the moment that the trend line is validated here, should be traded with end of day or end of week expiration date, so to medium to long term expiration dates. But every time price is reaching the 50% line, we should trade them with short-term expiration dates, like hourly and so on and so forth, and 2 hours, and even end of day. If, for example, if this is being tested on, I don't know, let's say 6 o'clock in the afternoon, that I would like to buy here call options with end of day expiration date, because until end of day there are only 3 to 4 hours being left. So this is area where I would like to buy call options, but with short to medium term expiration date. So short to medium term expiration date. This line here is the 50% line, and the 50% line of a channel that proved to be important support and resistance. Moreover, in terms of market geometry, whenever you look at such a situation, try to project any trend line either to the upside, or either to forecast it on the right side of the chart or on the left side of the chart. You might say, okay, why on the left side of the chart? Because on the left side of the chart is nothing that we are interested in. Well, it is just happening that sometimes price is, let's say, showing you that areas that you are looking for them to be resistance now, right, have proved to be areas of support. So exactly what we've discussed here, price coming here, it is support broken, and then even if price goes and makes new highs, it is making the highs in a previous support area that turned out to be resistance. So this is support, and this support area turns out to be resistance. What kind of a resistance? It is a dynamic resistance and becomes resistance from this moment of time, as you can see in many occasions. Here, and here, and here, and of course here, even if price in the end goes and makes a new high. We already knew that the previous support turns into resistance. So what to do? Well, definitely that I will like to buy put options to see what price is doing when it's testing this area here that was proved to be support from the point of a market geometry point of view. So buying again put options here, even though this has not even been validated. So by the time this is validated here, we know what to do, and I invite you to go and review this series again, as it is a classical example how a simple trend line, without even labeling the charts and without even labeling the waves using Elliott waves or stuff like that, it offers you a roadmap or a guidelines for trading binary options. Just use your imagination and look at previous support areas when price hesitated, or resistance areas again when price hesitated, and project future price action. With this, ending the mini project we had here on binaryoptions.net.au, it is being called The Beauty of a Trend Line, how to find important support and resistance areas based on a simple trend line. Bye-bye.